Today, we're going to learn about solving systems of two linear equations using a method called substitution. Substitution is a technique for solving systems of equations where one equation is solved for one variable, and then this expression is substituted into the other equation. This method helps us find the exact values of the variables quickly and easily. By the end of this video, you'll be comfortable solving systems of equations by substitution, step by step. Let's get started! The substitution method is based on the idea of solving one equation for one variable and then substituting that solution into the other equation to find the value of the second variable. This then allows us to get the value of the first variable. Let's break this down step by step. The first step is to solve for a variable in one equation. In this step, we take one of the two equations and solve for either x or y. This makes it easier to substitute into the second equation. Next, we take the expression we found in step 1 and substitute it into the second equation. This allows us to solve for the value of a single variable. After substitution, we can easily solve this one variable equation. This will give us the value of one variable. Now that we have the value of one variable, we substitute it back into the equation we solved in step 1 to find the value of the other variable. Finally, it's always a good idea to check your solution by plugging both values into the original system of equations. This will verify that they satisfy both equations. Let's see how it works on a few examples. Let's begin with solving the system of equations using substitution. First, we solve one equation for one variable. Let's solve the first equation for x. We can start with subtracting y from both sides. This gives us x equals 7 minus y. Now that we have this, we substitute this expression into the second equation. Now we have a one variable equation and can solve for y. Let's start by distributing the two and combining like terms. Let's now subtract 14 from both sides. If we divide both sides by negative 3, we get the value of y, which is 10 over 3. We can now substitute this value back into the equation, x equals 7 minus y, to find the value of x. For our last step, we can now check our solution by plugging both values into the original system of equations. Thus, the solution to the system of equations is x equals 11 over 3 and y equals 10 over 3. Let's now tackle a more challenging example. A movie theater sells tickets for two types of seats, standard and VIP. Standard tickets cost $8 and VIP tickets cost $12. On a particular day, the theater sold 200 tickets and made $1,760 in revenue. How many standard and VIP tickets were sold? Let's first define our variables. Let x represent the number of standard tickets sold, and y represent the number of VIP tickets sold. We can now set up two equations based on the information provided. The first equation comes from the total number of tickets sold, which is 200. The second equation comes from the total revenue of $1,760. We can now solve the system of equations using substitution. Let's start by solving the first equation for y. We can start with subtracting x from both sides. This gives us y equals 200 minus x. Now that we have this, we substitute this expression into the second equation. We now have a one variable equation and can solve for x. Let's start by distributing the 12 and combining like terms. Let's now subtract 2,400 from both sides. If we divide both sides by negative 4, we get the value of x, which is 160. We can now substitute this value back into the equation, y equals 200 minus x, to find the value of y. Now, we will check our solution by plugging both values into the original system of equations. Thus, given the options provided, the correct answer is option C. Great job today! Let's recap the key concepts we covered about solving systems of equations using substitution. To solve a system of equations using substitution, we first solve one equation for one variable. Next, we substitute the expression for the solved variable into the second equation. Then, we solve the resulting equation to find the value of the first variable. After that, we substitute this value back into the original equation to find the second variable. Finally, always check your solution by plugging both values back into the original equations. Keep up the great work, and soon substitution will be second nature.